In this class, we are going to discuss about flash or parallel type analog to digital converter. Up to now, we discussed about two converters, that is analog to digital converters, like counter type ADC, in which it will take 2 power n minus 1 cycles, clock cycles. That means it's very slow to convert analog to digital. And next we saw about some successive approximation type that was somewhat better compared to counter type. It will require n clock cycles for conversion of converting into n bit data. So now, for example, if we can convert that n bit data in single clock pulse, that is very better in applications like where we require fastest operation. For that purpose, we designed this flash or parallel type ADC. So this will convert your analog signal into digital signal. Here you can see, you can enter your analog input here, and here you will get at the output of priority encoder, you are going to get your digital output. Now, how you are going to design this circuit means, so first of all, you need to know how many number of bits are there. I am just considering for 3-bit operation. For example, if I am going to design for 3-bit output, then I need to consider 2 power n resistors. So that means 2 cube resistors means 8 resistors. You can observe 8 resistors here, R. So like that, with the same value, with a similar value, you need to consider 2 power n resistors. So for this, you require 2 power n resistors and 2 power n minus 1 comparators. So comparators means op amps. So here you can observe 7 op amps. That means 2 power n minus 1 means 8 minus 1, 7 op amps. So why you require 7 op amps means always your D naught bit is always grounded. So that's why you need to have only 7 op amps here to get the remaining bits. So how we are taking this V reference and V input, and how you are taking the data output from this structure means. So generally for any ADC, you need to give your input and you need to check with your reference. If reference and input, based on that reference voltage given and input analog voltage given, you are going to get some output at op amp. So here, whatever reference voltage that we are taking, we need to segregate that in 2 power n branches. You can see here, I taken V reference, that V reference I segregated in 2 power n branches. That means 7 by 8, 6 by 8, 5 by 8, 4 by 8, like this I taken. So nearly 7 branches, 2 power n minus 1 branches I segregated. Here your voltage is maybe 0. So here I am giving this reference voltage input to comparator at negative end, and whatever input voltage we are giving, that I am continuously giving to a positive input for each and every op amp. Now, for a given input voltage, if input voltage is higher than your reference voltage at particular point, then your op amp output is going to be 1, otherwise it's going to be 0. That means if your input voltage is greater than your reference voltage, for example, reference voltage here is 7 by 8 V reference, reference voltage here is 6 by 8 V reference, so like that. So if your V input is greater than V reference, then op amp output is equivalent to high voltage R1. If Vin is less than V reference, so op amp output is equivalent to low voltage or equivalent to 0. So like this we are getting. So here you can see, if for example my V reference is 8 and Vin is also 8, so here you are getting 7 by 8 into 8, 6 by 8 into 8, that 8 is going to cancel. You are getting 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 as your reference voltage. And as your input voltage is equivalent to 8, so in each and every case, so your Vin is going to greater than this reference voltage, then you are getting 1, 1, 1, 1, like this, and obviously D naught will be 0. So like this, you are going to take this output, op amp output, and next you are getting, you are having a 8-to-3 line priority encoder that is having a different circuit. Actually you can see the topics of priority encoder. So priority encoder is having XOR gates and some diodes internally. So according to that logic, what may be the equivalent value of that 8 bits to 3 bits, this priority encoder is going to convert that 8 bits to 3 bit digital data. So finally we are going to get our digital data here. But what data we will get as output of flash or parallel type, they are not asking. Why? Because that's a very big circuit of this priority encoder. So that's why they are not asking the topic in exams actually. So what they are asking is, how many comparators you require to form flash type ADC. So 2 power n minus 1 comparators we require, that's one important point. How many resistors you are having? So that is 2 power n resistors you need to consider. So and third very important point is, how many clock cycles it requires. Just it's need a single clock pulse. So when we given first, when we given power on for the circuit and we given single clock pulse, all circuits are giving parallelly, all circuits are, all op amps are providing output parallelly. So it just need a single clock pulse. But you can see the circuit complexity, it's having so many op amps, so many resistors, and priority encoder itself is having a big circuit with XOR gates, so many XOR gates and diodes nearly. You are having some 10 more diodes and here 7 XOR gates you are having in that 8-to-3 priority encoder. So that's why which is a bulky circuit, it will give you circuit complexity is as high and cost is also very high. But if you want the fastest operation, the fastest ADC among all ADCs, your flash type or parallel type ADC. So in exams on flash or parallel type, they will ask only 2 points, which is fastest ADC among all ADCs. This is one important gate point of view or any technical point of view question. Fastest analog to digital converter is flash or parallel type. Complexity is also high in this. More complex to design ADC is also flash or parallel type, and it will take only one clock cycle. So fastest ADC, it will take only one clock cycle, whereas counter type will take 2 power n minus 1 clock cycles, whereas successive approximation types takes n clock cycles, it will take only one clock cycle. So and then another important point is comparators, number of comparators are 2 power n minus 1 comparators. So this is about flash or parallel type analog to digital converter. In next class we are going to discuss dual and integrating type ADC and sigma delta ADCs also.